and just hearing mad stuff all night. Luckily, we were sectioned off because we were terrorists. We were classed as terrorists. They sectioned us off into like an area where you're not really in main flow with anybody else, because I don't know, you know, if you were a terrorist, you could organise or whatever. So mostly it was just 24 hours a day in the cell, but I'm with like, you know, two of my best friends, you know, so it could have been worse. I didn't think we were going to get out for a while, like just the way it was going. And I know what that country's like. We all know now, you know, like journalists are getting sent to prison for absolutely nothing. I mean, there was a woman recited a poem the other day on TV, which the government decided was not a poem that she should recite, and she's been arrested and she's in prison. Like, it's just crazy. I know people that are doing 3 years for insulting the government on Twitter there. So, you know, whilst people, oh yeah, I love having good parties and that in Bodrum, like, remember, there were hundreds of thousands of people, Turks, Kurds, other people, all in prison for nothing, you know. It's a totalitarian vibe. So, unfortunately, I kind of knew that. It wasn't as bad back then as it is now, but I knew, like, this is bad. So I didn't think we was going to get out. I thought at least a year maybe, but then one day they were just like, right, you're out, get out. I was like, what? Like, they're like, you're out. So, all right, cool, we're going home. And then we got taken to another prison. So I was like, he was like, you're going home? I was like, when, today? He was like, don't know. So I was like, right, I got put in another prison. Then we're in main flow. So basically the last prison was a deportation prison. So we're getting deported. So we had to wait 3 days. Or was it four? I forget. But like a few days basically to be like, right, you're going to be processed. But whilst you're being processed, you're in this prison. And the other people getting processed were Chechen ISIS fighters who had been fighting in Syria as volunteers. They'd come across the border to get, you know, treatment in the hospital or to, you know, have a rest from the battle or whatever, because the border with Turkey and Syria was a very porous back then. You could go back and forth, and they'd been caught as well. So there, obviously, the authorities arrested them. You're going to get deported back to Chechnya or wherever. And we ended up in the same prison. So we're being processed with all these ISIS guys. I never forget, there was one lad who had open bullet wounds in his arm, just like pus dripping out of them, because he'd obviously been shot on the border and was just, I don't know, it was just mad. And we just sat there like drinking tea with them, like in this room. Like, and the maddest thing happened with me and my friend. Unfortunately, my friend Rasul, he was left in. He was in longer than us because he's Kurdish, you know, but he got out as well, thank God. But so me and Phil are in there. And luckily it wasn't just ISIS. There was loads of like refugees as well, like who basically saved our lives, like really good lads, load of Afghan refugees who like I owe my life to, basically. They just like protected us. They were like, come with us. These lot is ISIS. Come with us. Like, you know, we're chill. Like Muslims, but we're not extremists. Don't worry. And we was like, cool, cool, cool. So they were like, come with us, sit with us. And we was watching the dead of TV room there. Like main flow, you've got your own kind of cell. It's, you can come in and out anytime. And we had the TV room and like we're there watching Al Jazeera. And then me and my friend came up on the telly. And like they were like, oh, you know, Jake Hanrahan, Philip Pendlebury released from prison. And I was like, hang on, I'm in prison. Like, I'm watching this in prison. So this lad sat with us, just burst out laughing, and he was like, you're still in here, this Afghan lad, Ali. And he was like, you know, you two all right, come with us. So we went with him. He gave us like a bunk, so we slept in his room and hit with another lad, another Afghan lad, and this Iranian guy. And they were just like, look, we're going to look after you. Palestinian lad as well, lovely lad. And that was probably the maddest 3 days of my life. Like, the maddest three. Basically, we found out afterwards that, I don't know how true it was, but I believe it. One of the Afghan lads that was in our room spoke great English. He messaged me afterwards on Skype, because like, we kind of, you weren't meant to, but we slipped contact details, put him in our shoes. And he was like, oh, by the way, you know when there was that big argument in our hallway? I said, yeah, what was that about? Why were they kept coming to you? He's like, well, they wanted to lure you into the bathroom, and like there was like, you know, communal showers. He's like, oh, they wanted to slit your throat, because obviously we were like, you know, kafir or whatever, like we were their number one enemy. And he was like, oh, I was, you know, telling them, if you do that, I'm gonna like, you know, do whatever, tell the guards or whatever. And I was like, oh, I was like, what? And he's like, I didn't tell you because I knew you'd be worried. And I was like, yeah, like, you know what I mean. There's one day where I knew something was wrong, because they had like Ali, the lad I said, he come in with a lighter, and he'd made a knife out of a lighter. So we got a teaspoon, he'd sharpened the handle and then like melted the lighter and like stuck the kind of teaspoon in the lighter. So we had like this makeshift like shank in the room, and he was like, don't worry. And I was like, oh fuck. I was like, why are you telling me don't worry? Like, you know what I mean? Like, there's obviously some problem. But yeah, like basically these like legend, like, Afghan refugees, and this Palestinian lad just basically saved us. And then one day they come in like, right, you're gone, armed guard all the way to the airport, and they put us on a plane. Within like that same day, we went from being in jail, and then I remember me and my mate went out to Brick Lane and got a haircut, and I was like, mad. I was like, ain't this mad, like the maddest experience. And I was 25 years old, so